Machiavellian is Illuminati all through your body. The blow's like a 12-gauge shotty.
Feel me? And God said he should send his one begotten son to lead the wild into the ways of the man. Follow me. Eat my flesh, flesh of my flesh. Come with me. Hail Mary, run quick, see. What do we have here now?
I ain't a killer, but don't push me. Revenge is like the sweetest joy next to getting pussy. Picture paragraphs unloaded, wise words being quoted. Beat the weakness in the rap game and sold it. Bow down, pray to God, hoping that he's listening. Seeing niggas coming for me, my diamonds when they glistening. Now pay attention, best man, please, father. I'm a ghost, in these killing fields. Hail Mary, catch me if I go. Don't go deep inside the solitary mind of a madman. Screams in the dark, evil lurks, enemies see me flee. Activate my hate, let it break, till I'm flaming. Set trip, empty out my clip, never stop to aim. Some say the game is all corrupted, fucked in this shit. Stuck, niggas is lucky if we bust out this shit. And plus, mama told me never stop until I bust a nut. Fuck the world and they can't adjust. It's just this way, oh, Hail Mary. Come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see. What you be having now? Do you wanna ride or die? Centuries is back with promise makers. Never realized the precious time that bitch niggas is wasting. Institutionalized, I live my life a product made to crumble. I'm too hardened for a smile, way too crazy to be humble. We ballin', catch me, father, please, cause I'm ballin'. In the liquor store, that's the Hennessy I hear callin'. Can I get some more? Hell, till I reach hell, I ain't scared. Mama checkin' in my bedroom, I ain't there. I got a head with no screws in it. What can I do? One life to live, but I got nothing to lose. Just me and you on a one-way trip to prison. Selling drugs, we all wrapped up in this living. Like the studs to my homeboys and Clinton Max doing they bid. Raise hell to this real shit and feel this. When they turn out the lights, I'll be there in the dark. Love an eternal through my heart. Now Hail Mary, nigga, come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see. What do we have here now? Do you wanna ride or die? La da 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 da. Come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see. What do we have here now? Do you wanna ride or die? La da 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 da.
They got an APB out on my thug family. Since Outlaws run these streets like these scandalous freaks. Our enemies dying now. Walk around half dead, head down. K blasted off a hand and see. Now I'm twisted, blistered, and high. Visions of me, thug living, getting me by. Forever live, and I multiply, survive by thugs. When I die, they won't cry unless they coming with slugs.
Peep the whole scene and whatever's going on around me. Brain kinda cloudy, smoked out, feeling rowdy. Ready to wet the party up. And whoever in that motherfucker, nasty new street slugger. My heat, deep suckers on the regular. Mashing in a stolen black act, Integra, cock back. Dicky seconds to the draw, that's when I'm dead in your feet first. You got a nice gap, but my heat's worse. From a thug to preaching church, I gave you love. Now you eating dirt, needing work. And I ain't the nigga to put you on, cause word is born. When I was broke, I had to hustle till dawn. That's when the sun came up. It's only one way up. Hold your head, stay up. So all my niggas, get your pay and wait up.
If it's on, then it's on. We rake, beat, breaks, outlaws on a paper chase. Can you relate to the shit I don't got? Be the shit I gotta take. Dealing with fate, hoping God don't want to gate. If it's on, then it's on. We rake, beat, breaks, outlaws on a paper chase. Can you relate to the shit I don't got? Be the shit I gotta take. Dealing with fate, hoping God don't close the gate.
Traveling on this weary road. Sometimes life can be a heavy load. But we ride, riding like a bullet. Hail Mary,
Hail Mary.
We won't worry, everything will hurry. We'll sing like a beautiful tree. We won't worry, everything will curry. Yes, we free like a bird in the tree. We're running from the penitentiary. This is the time for we liberty. Hail Mary, Hail Mary.
Ride or die, la 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 la.
Westside, Outlaws, Machiavelli the Don, Solo, Illuminati, 7 days.
Good morning, good evening, good night, and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's your nighttime, right time DJ, DJ Music, and welcome to another episode of the Chop Shop. As always, here in the Chop Shop with me, holding down court there, ladies and gentlemen, my co-host and my good friend, Shaw Willie. But tonight, we got a special added attraction there, ladies and gentlemen. We got one of my great DJs from Classic R&B Jams. I'm talking about one and only DJ Dread Headset. Y'all go ahead and turn your mics on in and come on in and say hello to everybody, if you don't mind, please.
I don't mind. Thank you. Thank you. Hello. Hello, everyone.
Hey, how everybody doing?
Alrighty. How y'all doing? Y'all both in pretty much in kind of like in the same area. What's going on up in that y'all part of the world?
Lots of traffic, conventions, air and water show, back to school parade, all kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Fleet Week and shit like that, huh? Yeah. We know why we're all here tonight, folks. All three of us, we've been following the political sphere here the last couple of weeks, especially now that Vice President Harris has chosen a running mate. We waited for about, a week or so after she made the announcement and became the Democratic nominee for presidency that's about to come up. Of course, we all know Joe Biden stepped aside. I make a long story short. Y'all want to take a guess? Anybody? You want to take a guess? Guess who mad?
Who mad?
The MAGA folks with their head leader, Trump.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, he mad. He mad as hell. And he went on Fox News to express just how mad he was. Now, before I go any further, I'll start with the ladies in the room. Sharp, given the... I'm not asking you who you're going to vote for, what your political preference, but given what you've seen of the two candidates, who would you think has a better shot to become the next president of the United States?
I would say VP Harris, since she's not talking about cutting Social Security and all them other things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What about you, Dreadhead said? Who do you think?
Oh, I'm Harris all day.
Mm. No, you're taking the bias out of just from what you see in the news, because I'm Harris all day myself. But just from what you see in the news, who do you think has a better shot to become the next president?
Well, from the basic understanding that I always had about elections is that it's really more people on the Democratic side than the Republican side. That's why they cheat to win. They cheat to do everything. And
good point.
You know, the only way they win, and think about this, in the last few presidential elections, no Republican has won the popular vote, period.
Yeah, right. And that's absolutely true, folks. And I think that's one of the reasons why the Republicans want to try to get away with that popular vote business, because they feel once they sealed up the Electoral College, the popular vote didn't mean nothing. But correct me if I'm wrong, either one of y'all can do this, but the popular vote means the people.
Yeah, yes. I think that that the popular vote should be the side by all.
I think that should be the deciding factor, not the Electoral College. I think they have that ass backwards. What y'all think?
I agree.
Right.
Unless they want to hire me as being, I work for them.
Well, sure. She just threw out a resume there, folks. So if anybody out there listening, contact me. I'm her agent. I'm going to need something up front.
I want my cut too. You know what I'm saying? Right. I went in on this.
but as I was saying, folks, of course, we know Vice President Harris chose as a running mate Democratic from Senator from Minnesota by the name of Walz. And it seems to be that a lot of people it's agreeing with that on the Democratic side. They're agreeing with the candidate. And from to me, he was kind of obscure. I didn't really hear too much about him until they made the announcement. So I went and looked up the guy. He's a military veteran. No matter how you look at it, he served in the armed forces. Well, of course, he wasn't a Marine, but I'm not going to hold that against him. He's 24 years. He served his country. He was a school teacher, elementary school teacher, middle school teacher. So a lot of those traits, what he's done, now he's a governor, a senator, whatever. So he went to politics. So a lot of what he's done, I would, from the brief history that I've checked up on him, he seems to be a people person.
Yes.
Would y'all agree with that? I don't know how I wouldn't guess to know how much you know about him, but if I'm correct, if I'm wrong, but the first time y'all really heard about him was the day they announced his candidacy. Am I wrong?
Yeah, that was my first time. Correct.
I've heard of him because you know he was in Congress as well for a while. So
yeah, he's been in Congress for a while, and I think the first time I really heard of him is when the folks up there tried to get him. I think they either went to his house, surrounded his house with MAGA signs and stuff like that, trying to get him. They were a little upset with him because he didn't want to certify the alternate state of electors or something like that. So that was the first time I really heard of him. It's a real, real smart man, right? But anyway, folks, we're going to get to our first clip here. And Donald Trump, of course, he went on his favorite, dare I call this news show, Fox News. And he gave his opinion of Vice President Harris, Vice President running mate choice. This is what he had to say. Now, as we stop, we're going to listen to this, folks, and we'll probably have to stop it a few times. But I want y'all to listen before I say this. I want you to listen to any part of this conversation that Donald Trump's talks anything about policy. That seems to be the sticking point for a lot of these folks. Policy. Donald Trump has policy. When is he going to present them? Because he sure didn't hear. Okay, so without further ado, folks, let's get to our first clip.
This morning, it just may be the most far left agenda in our country's history on a presidential ticket.
Because the Democratic ticket is now set, Governor Tim Walz's record in Minnesota includes everything from tax-funded health care for illegals to so-called gender-affirming care for minors, just to name a few, as we've been doing.
Okay, we're going to stop it right there automatically. We know that's not true. Although there is a migrant problem, he's not funding that type of what you just said. But this is Fox News, folks, so you're going to hear a lot of that. You're going to hear a bunch of flat out lies. No fact checkers. They're starting out the box lying.
This morning,
joining us now for his first TV interview, his reaction to have the right to go to the White House and become the 47th president. Let's welcome the 45th president of the United States, GOP presidential nominee, President Donald Trump. Mr. President, welcome back.
Thank you very much.
So
thank you.
Your reaction to Governor Tim Walz joining Kamala Harris to go against you and J.D. Vance.
I would say my reaction is I can't believe it. I never thought this was going to be the one that was picked. I know him a little bit. I helped him very much during the riots because his...
Ashar and said, and anytime you guys want me to stop this, if you hear something that you want to speak on or something that that I might miss, by all means, just say, hey, stop that or pause that for a minute, all right?
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So off the bat, this was a time for me coming out the box that Donald Trump should have been talking about policy. But listen to what he does coming out the box. Okay? Anything y'all want to hit on before I push this go button?
No, go ahead.
Go ahead.
All right.
This house was surrounded by people that were waving an American flag. Doesn't sound like very bad people. And he called me and he was very concerned, very, very concerned it was going to get out of control. They only had one guard. I guess it was at the mansion or at his house in some form. And he called me. I said, what do you want? That I'm a good person. And I did. I put out the word. I said, he's a good person. I hope everything's good. And everybody put down their flags and took their flags with them. But they took their American flags and their MAGA flags and they left. It was thousands of people. And that was the first time I said, wow, that's very interesting. And he called me back and he thanked me very much. That's my only thing I ever had to do with him. He's a very, very liberal man. And he's a shocking pick, and I'm thrilled. I could not be more thrilled.
Yeah, I mean.
Okay, let's stop that right there. First of all, that was a complete lie. A complete lie. It was his fault.
I swear, I feel like I got showtime at the Apollo every time that man talks.
Right. I mean, right.
I can't stop that.
It was his fault. He was calling the governor at the time he was a governor. He was calling Trump saying, hey, your folks is down here trying to get me to do some shit. It's illegal. Call them off. They're trying to tear the damn place down.
And then he told him, okay, he's good. He's a good person. You guys leave.
Right. You hear that?
Right. And he just left.
Right. They just left.
Okay. He's a good person. Let's go. Let's pack up and go home.
Right.
Oh, boy, boy.
Ooh, it's going to be rough, folks. It's going to be rough to get through these few minutes here. A lie don't care who tell it. The lie was in full effect here in this interview, folks.
Hey, I want to throw this out there.
Sure.
Do you think that Trump suffers from a contagious form of diabetes?
Dementia, diabetes, whatever you want to put to it. Is he a KT? If you look up the word liar, you know, there used to be different little, you know, there's only one thing now, and it's a picture of Trump there. That's it.
Yeah, no definition. Diabetic, man.
That's all you need. That's all you need is one picture of Trump. That's a liar.
Every time you play him, you should follow that up with the LL Cool J song, You're a Liar.
That's a lie. You're a liar. I got this Japanese girl named Lee, man. Wipes my butt because you wear diapers. That's why. Let's continue.
When they selected him, it's really a gift for you because this election is all about the issues. And all of y'all have records. You've been the president. We know where the economy stood, what your record is. We know what Kamala Harris's record is, and we know what his record is. And they are extremely progressive. Talk about how you're going to handle this on the campaign trail. Will you just really hone in on how they voted in the past?
Well, I am. I'm going to be doing that, what he wants. If you look at his record with no walls, no security, let everybody in, he's worse than they are. You know, nobody knew how radical left she was, but he's a smarter version of her, if you want to.
Wait, let me just say this, folks. In 2011, Donald Trump wrote a check to, and then she was running for the state prosecutor of California. Donald Trump wrote a $5,000 check to Kamala Harris. 2011.
He forgot that?
No, we forgot. You know he was a Democrat before he was a Republican. I mean, for him to be hardcore Republican now, you know, that's like you take a blood in the crypt. And the crip moves into the blood neighborhood, and all of a sudden,
it don't work that way. Blood in, blood out, crip in, crip out. If we catch you at the wrong side of town, especially where she's from, Oakland, let's continue.
I know the truth. He's probably about the same as Bernie Sanders. He's probably more so than Bernie Sanders. She is more so than Bernie Sanders. That's got to be your guide, Bernie Sanders, and it's not a great guide. But there's never been a ticket like this. This is a ticket that would want this country to go communist immediately, if not sooner. We want no security. Mm-hmm. We want no anything. He's very heavy into transgender. Anything transgender he thinks is great. And he's not where the country is on anything.
Mr. President,
this is a shocking pick. And I think it's very insulting to.
Well, listen, whether you agree with the alphabet community, and that's trying to say that respectfully, I think most of the country is for the alphabet community rights. Correct me if I'm wrong on that.
I agree with you.
Sid?
Yeah.
So I think with her choosing this guy, Walz, as the vice president, I think that would bring more of that community into the Democratic folds. Wouldn't y'all think so?
Definitely their money.
Right. So they're definitely their money. And also, I'm sure Pete Buttigieg, which is openly a gay man, I'm sure he's going to have a lot to do with bringing that community in. So, in a nutshell, don't you think Donald Trump just shot himself in the foot?
Yep, because he sounds like he's negative against the whole community.
Right.
And you know, the irony is that remember, it was a few years ago, the Republican Party was going in on the gay community real tough, and then all of a sudden, all these Republicans got outed.
Yeah.
Remember the guy from the Denver airport? Right. He was trying to hit on a dude in the bathroom.
Right. Man, from grown men to little boys, that's what the Republican Party was being exposed to.
Mm-hmm.
It sure was. It sure were. And if there wasn't grown men and little boys, they was out in Alabama chasing little girls at the high school.
A lot of divorces.
Okay.
A lot of divorces.
All right. Let's continue.
Jewish people, and I think it's very insulting to people.
Her husband is Jewish. Am I wrong?
Oh, I think he is Jewish.
Well, I don't know if he's Jewish or not. But
I think he is. I think he's a Jewish. I think he's of Jewish, Jewish descent. I do believe he is. Y'all correct me if I'm not if I'm wrong.
I think he is, though.
Leave me a comment down there in the chat room if I'm wrong. But I do believe he practices the Jewish faith.
Want security? I think it's very insulting to anything having to do with making America great again.
Mr. President, is it true that you're... Because there was one reporter who was at a J.D. Vance event yesterday, and there were some flyers printed up talking about how J.D. Vance, about how Mr. Shapiro was a fraud and corrupt and a lying con man and stuff like that. So it sounds like you were ready to take on him.
That sounds like what you would say.
Well, look, I'm no big fan of Josh Shapiro. I know the state very well. I think we're leading pretty good in that state, but I would have said that it would have been a better choice. I would have said others would have better choice. And interesting, just about all of them, except this one, is better than her. She is not nearly as good as the people she was looking at. I know them all in one form or another. And in fact, it was a poll done, and there were some studies done. She's the worst of the group, and she's the one that's leading it. Look at this decision. This is a really bad decision for the country. You know, ultimately, I want the country to have good decisions, because ultimately what we want is for the country to do well. The country can't do well with these two people.
Okay, let me ask a question. Has he answered any question yet?
No, he danced around everything like he always do.
He mentioned the people, but not what was asked directly. So he danced around it like Zed said.
Okay, well, here we go. I just got my answer, whether he was Jewish or not. I appreciate that, Char. Let me read this, what you put in the background here. When Harris assumed office, his name is Imhoff. His last name became the first second gentleman, whereas instead of the first lady, he's the first second gentleman of the United States. He's also the first Jewish spouse of a U.S. vice president. So there you have it, folks. So Trump, strike two. You just alienated the Jewish community. Am I wrong, folks?
I hope he did.
He just did. he did just by this statement. If you're watching Fox News right now, or matter of fact, if you're watching any news, you don't think this is not a soundbite?
I mean, I feel they should use it. Yeah. Definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
Let's continue. Let's see who else he insults. So far, two for two on the insult train.
They're very similar, and you know, you would have thought she would have reached out and got somebody that's got some different, because her record on security is horrible. She was a border czar, which she doesn't admit it now. You know, the only thing they have going is the media will play off all of the bad things that happened during her term. She was so bad that 5 weeks ago they wanted to remove her because she was unthinkable to be president. They were going to go with anyone. And then they were afraid that they would offend people if they did that. And all of a sudden, inch by inch, and then she ends up taking over. Now this.
Did y'all hear that? Did y'all ever hear that 5 weeks ago? 5 weeks ago, who do we think was running for president? Did I miss something?
The current president. It's only been, what, 2 weeks now?
Right. It's only been, what, two and a half weeks best. At best, that he dropped out of the race.
Right.
Is Donald Trump... go ahead, say it.
Well, I was just going to throw in there that, you know when if they debate and he try to bring that point up, you know the only thing that she has to say is that we had a border bill that was ready to be signed into law, and you blocked it.
Absolutely. And
he's not going to be able to get around that.
Right. And absolutely. And my next thing is, after you blocked the border bill, show me where any of the White House description says borders are. Where do you find that at? Where's that job listed?
You know, I've heard that, but
that's a term they made up.
Okay. I do know that they, you know, us covering the whole border thing, realizing this is a planned thing, then of course this is going to happen. So,
right. But again, right. You're right, Sharp, because I mean, when we first started covering the border crisis, eventually you and I, we could both, and I think said at one point in time, you joined us, but at one point in time, we all came to the same conclusion that they were going to use this in the closer we got to the election, this was going to be the Republicans' focal point because they have nothing else to run on.
Yeah, this is supposed to have been their ace in the hole.
Mm. Right. Yep. So let's continue and see who else he insults.
Same press that thought she was the worst vice president in history, which is true, going along with the worst president in history. And he went down after the debate, and there was nothing much they could do. They tried to come back. Then they brought her in, and everybody said, it'll never be her. She's so bad. She's incompetent. And after they studied it a little bit, they realized it's not going to be so easy to do. So they say, well, look, the press is going to do whatever we want because the press is a rigged deal. The press is the media, outside of you people, of course, but the media is so they're trying to build her up to the next Margaret Thatcher liberal version. And I don't believe it's going to happen. I hear she's hasn't taken one interview. She would never do an interview like this. That I can.
She hasn't taken one interview. The woman's been all plastered all over TV. Where the fuck you been? She's doing rallies. Just today she did a record-breaking rally in Detroit. Just today, just a few hours ago.
She did one in Detroit. I know she did one in Wisconsin earlier.
Right. She left Wisconsin and went to Detroit.
And the Wisconsin rally was packed, too.
Packed. Packed.
Matter of fact, I was just looking at the news, and they was talking about her being in LeClaire, Wisconsin, and they said that the mile of cars waiting to get there was 2 miles long.
Too long, and the one in Detroit, folks, they span as far as you could see, just like a sea of people. And just like you said, Shar, outside of Fox, you know, he's like, everybody outside of Fox is fucked up news.
Right. That's something.
I knew you was going Right. I knew you was going to pick up on that. I was like, Sean, catch this. Outside of Fox. He tried to say it slick too, didn't he? Outside of you guys.
Right.
Well, you know, Fox has no choice. They paid almost $800 million because of him, so.
$787 million.
Woo.
And they say it ain't over.
You would think that they learned their lesson, right?
Shit. I'd be that Trump would be the no, you can't even come across the street here. Hell no.
You can't even touch a microphone here, buddy. Don't even call. We blocking you.
Okay.
Shit. We gonna let you back in the door.
Somebody calls me $787 million. Yes. They ain't never got to worry about me talking to them.
Somebody cost me $7.87. They ain't got to worry about me talking to them no more.
Sound rough.
Let's continue. Right, I need all of that. I'm not going to dope for a dollar if you owe me. Here we go.
Yeah, with any network, she doesn't do interviews because she can't answer questions. I don't know how she debates. I heard she's sort of a nasty person, but not a good debater. But we'll see, because we'll be debating her, I guess, in the pretty near future. It's going to be announced fairly soon, but we'll be debating her. I'd like to see it on Fox, by the way.
He'd like to see it on Fox, by the way.
Right.
I was trying my damnedest not to choke this down, because right. I knew it was coming.
The same people that should be staying as far away from Trump as possible. You want to have a debate on their stage?
Right.
You can cost these people $800 million.
Come on up. We got another $787 million we could throw at you. Come on up. The fuck? No, okay. Let's okay. Straight face.
I'll try.
Wait. Straight face. Stop it.
Doing my best.
Straight face. Exhibit. Do y'all think that Vice President Harris has any worry about debating Donald Trump?
No. Not at all. But I don't blame her for not wanting to go to Fox.
Right. Why would I go? But that's like putting a pork chop and sending her into a lion's den. Why would you do that?
But I think that, you know, that she would be able to hold on. Like, I don't think that they'd be able to touch
her. I think so too, Sid. I really believe so. I think whatever she decides, and to be quite honest with you, no disrespect, Sean, but I think quite honestly, just on principle, she would accept that challenge. Just to say, hey, I ain't scared of you motherfuckers. What you think?
Where's the band?
You know, I'm kind of, you know, in the middle of that, because I believe that, you know, if she did it, nice. If she didn't, even better. Because, I mean, you know, that's throwing an egg in his face. Like, dude.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. But, again, so I don't think she has no fear of debating him. I really don't. I can't see that. This is a strip away the political thing. This is an educated woman here, folks.
You know, and picking up on what Sid just stated, mm-hmm. that would really work. Because I know I use that in my own personal life. I don't have to talk to you. I don't have to say anything to you. You figure it out on your own. And that would be really good. Let him go around misquoting, lying, doing the thing he's doing. But on the other side, if you just that type of person, you're interested, come over here, we're going to tell you the truth or whatever, and if you're throwing a lie, just fact check us. But we already right. know everything they try to fact check him. He's lying in between lying.
Right. We're going to fact check his ass.
She demonstrated that today, too, because I don't know if y'all heard.
Remember that. Y'all keep
her plane landed in Wisconsin, and J.D. Vance's plane landed in Wisconsin, and he walked over there. And she looked at him. I think she gave him the finger. And they all got in their SUVs and drove off. Like, left the man standing there making him look stupid. So,
damn.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, she played him. She didn't even give him an opportunity.
Good.
Good. Good, good. So let's continue here, folks. Let's see who else he's going to insult or lie on.
I can see it. My preference would be Fox, but we have to debate.
Do you have an announcement, Mr. Are you working stuff out behind the scenes? Because we haven't heard about it yet.
No, but I can tell you every network loves me very much right now. They love me very much. I've never been so loved by CBS and by ABC Fake News. And by NBC. And by NBC. No, they're all in love with me now, so that, you know, I say yes, because it's up to me, obviously, right. Also.
But on the debate,
the most important thing is we get debate. I think debates are very important, and I think she'll be exposed, just like Biden was exposed. Nobody knew Biden was that bad, and then he was exposed during the debate, and they tried to have a series of comebacks after that, and they didn't work out too well, and they viciously.
Okay, hey, Char, remember I said this when we had the debate. No, they don't cut him off at all. Remember, I said this debate was not about Trump. This was a referendum on Biden.
Yes.
And that's exactly what it was. That's exactly what it was. That's all it was. Nothing more, nothing less. Let's put him out there and let's see if he can hold his own. We see he didn't fare too well.
Because the Democrats didn't fare too well neither, because everything that came out of his mouth
was lying. Right. And they didn't focus
on
that.
He lied the whole debate.
Right. But that's the point, said. This was not about Trump, and it was not about fact checking his lies. This was all about showing the country, or trying to show the country, for some folks, that Biden was too old. That's what that debate was about. It was not about fact checking Trump, because if they wanted to, they could have it any time. At any time. Let's continue.
Overthrew him. I mean, he was overthrown in it. Using every trick in the book, they overthrew him. It was pretty amazing, actually, to watch.
I want to come back to the debate. Just to close this up, you're in litigation with George Stephanopoulos on ABC. Right. And the judge says, the suit's going to go forward. So how could you go on ABC, especially if he's going to be one of the moderators?
Well, you could use that as an excuse. I could use that. I've said that. Is there a conflict? And, you know, there might be George Slopidopoulos, and he's got problems, and, you know, they've got problems. But if they're going to have I guess David Muir is going to be the host in that case. And Martha, and they're great. And I'd love to see it on Fox, but, you know, it takes two to tango.
Well, maybe you get two.
She doesn't want a debate. Look, she doesn't want a debate. She wants to say, I don't want a debate, but I do want a debate. You know, when it came to Biden, I accepted everything. I accepted Jake Tapper. I accepted everything, because he didn't want a debate. After I accepted everything, the only thing I said, let's stand up. They wanted to sit down at a desk. I said, that's not going to look so great. So I said, but I accepted everything. And, you know, pretty much that's the way I do it right now, because I want to debate her. I think it's important for the country that we debate. Now, where it is, I'm all for Fox. I'd like to see it on Fox. I think Fox would do a really good job. But two people have to agree.
All right, Mr. President, let's talk about some of the issues. Mr. Walz, Governor Walz said.
Okay. Again, name calling, like you said in the back there, Char. Stephanopoulos, right. Respected journalist, mm-hmm. You just insulted this man.
Mm-hmm.
Your thoughts?
Then he threw out that he would love to debate on Fox, of course. Fox would do a great job, of course.
Right.
Coming from Donald Trump, I don't know why they just don't call him that. Just call him Donald Trump. Trump. No, not Trump. Trump.
Trump. Right. That would be Donald Trump. I think the Lincoln Project is probably the closest folks that's going to call him that. I don't know why. We don't fight clean, do we, sir? No. He'd have been called a Trump a long time ago. This ain't Donald Trump. This is Donald Trump. Come on, sucker.
And, you know, I really believe that the reason why he wanted Biden, because, you know, in the normal political landscape, with everything that Trump got going, well, you know what? I'm not going to call him Trump no more. Everything Trump got going on, it would have been brought up every time he opened his mouth. And I think one of the reasons why a lot of people didn't like Biden is that he wasn't fighting. He wasn't fighting back. Let Trump say anything he want to say, do anything he want to do, but you're not even fighting back. You know, calling him what he is, he's a convict.
Right.
He's convicted.
Right.
Now one or two counts.
34.
Right.
Right. With more in the wing, and no mention to it. But again, like I said, it wasn't about Trump and his lies. It was a referendum on his state of mind, and I'm talking about Biden and the way he looked. And I hate to say it, he looked like a defeated, feeble old man on the stage that night.
Yeah, I had not seen him in a long time, and when I was watching it, I'm like, I'm staring at the screen. I'm like, huh? And they used a lot of AI to actually make him look more animated.
They sure did. They sure did. Absolutely. But let's continue here.
This about you, that you don't understand kitchen table issues. Listen.
Donald Trump's not fighting for you or your family. He never sat at that kitchen table like the one I grew up at, wondering how we were going to pay the bills. He sat his country club up in Mar-a-Lago, wondering how he can cut taxes for his rich friends.
Mr. President, what's your response to that?
Well, I think it's just the opposite. I think if you see the vote, those people are all voting for me, the people that he's talking about with the kitchen table. And I was not always sitting at Mar-a-Lago either, but I was sitting at lots of other places. And built an unbelievable business, one of the greatest businesses. I built a business that is phenomenal. That's been really determined now how good it is. And, you know,
y'all need to go get some water. We know that's an absolute. We know that's an absolute. Right, right.
I just pulled my Hennessy straight and I ready.
Right. I don't drink shit, but I'll take a shot on that one because that was hard to swallow right there.
Brother, I'm gonna pass the bottle to you. Cause
good Lord have mercy. Y'all take a drink on this. Light them up, smoke them up if you got them. Now you got to be high to listen to this shit.
I was just gonna ask, you know, can he show me the job posting? You know,
right. And wait a minute. According to you, didn't your pop leave you with like $1 million or so?
No, how many are about $4 million?
Okay, how many? Right. How many folks you and y'all like to left you with $4 million?
No.
Okay. Let's continue here. So far,
I could have a very simple life and a very good life and continue to do what I love. I love business and I love creating jobs, and that's what we're doing. We'll be creating jobs at a level that you've never seen before. If you look at our administration, the most successful administration from the economy standpoint there ever was. There's never been any administration that was even close, numbers-wise. And by the way, they had inflation, the level which our country probably has never seen. You know, they say you go back 72 years. Well, I think we probably never have seen inflation like that. And it's killing the same people that he's talking about. It's killing. Inflation has destroyed their administration, and they have no idea.
Well, round six on the lies. I just did a loose nigga roundup this weekend.
Oh, wow.
And I showed the inflation from 1960 to 2022. If you go back and look at that same chart that I looked at, the only time inflation was was killing the Americas when the Republicans was in office. So you leave that out, Trump. I think it may be one or two Democratic presidents had a high inflation rate.
Well, I will say this. That is the one thing that I think would have hurt Biden and could possibly hurt Kamala is the economy. But every time when the economy went to hell in the basket, it was always the Democrats that came in and fixed it. When Obama left, we had a surplus. When Clinton left, we had a surplus.
And that's what Trump that's what Trump was basing his economy on, the surplus that he walked into.
Right. And he's lying, saying that he built that surplus. And
but he didn't.
Lie.
But that's that's the talking points. He'll say it in a minute. Listen, let's continue.
Yeah, what to do about it? It's getting worse, and you had a crash the other day of over 1,000 points. It's a very bad situation that we're going in. We could end up in a depression if these people are reelected.
So let's talk about anti-Semitism. Van Jones had an interesting thing to say about anti-Semitism. He says this on CNN. It's just because he's a moderate. They're talking about Shapiro not getting the job. Or is there some anti-Jewish bias there? He goes, you also have anti-Semitism. It's gotten marbled into this party. You can't be for the Palestinians without being anti-Jewish bigot. But there are some anti-Jewish bigots out there, and there's some disquiet now. And there has to be how much that just happened. How much is this pick, I guess he's saying, caving into the anti-Jewishness, anti-Semitism that's marbled into the party? Do you think that's marbled into the party? Because if I could bring in something else that's new, CNN did a poll, and they asked New York Jewish New Yorkers, if the election was today, who you'd vote for. And for the first time maybe ever since Ronald Reagan, you have a one-point lead over Kamala Harris among Jewish voters in New York.
That is an absolute lie. That is an absolute lie. Absolute lie. Go look for yourself. Among Jewish voters, whether Donald Trump or Kamala Harris has the lead.
Action to Van Jones and that poll.
Well, we're going to try and win New York, and that hasn't been done for many, many decades, as you know, but we're trying to win New York, and we're very close to doing it. And probably that's another reason I was somewhat surprised. I think that any Jewish person who votes for a Democrat, or in this case, these people, but who votes for a Democrat, should have their head examined. They are so bad.
So do y'all think now if he didn't alienate the Jewish population just now based on Vice President Harris's husband, ethnicity or heritage or his faith, do you think he just eliminated them with that statement?
That is very insulting to say. If I don't do this, then something's wrong with me. Terrible.
I didn't say that he did. Right. That's what he said. Sid, you want to touch on that?
I'm with Shar.
Let's continue.
You know, the thing, I just don't understand how this man gets away with spewing all this.
He's on Fox. He's on Fox. But I hate to say it, he would get away with a lot of this on CNN, too. Because remember, when Caitlin Collins did that interview, she rarely fact-checked it.
That's true.
Bad. If you look, they are so bad to Jewish people, what they've done and the way they talk and their policy and everything else, far beyond just what happened, because everyone thought it was going to be Shapiro. It turned out not to be Shapiro. I have very little doubt that it was, you know, not for the reason we're talking about. It was because of the fact that he's Jewish and they think they're going to offend somebody else. And you wouldn't feel very comfortable if you're in Israel right now with this team. This is the worst team ever assembled for a Jewish person or for Israel, either one. The worst team ever assembled. This is a team that will not be there. And I think I'm going to get a tremendous amount of Jewish votes. I think I was doing fine there, but I think it's a big difference. Mm-hmm. Traditionally, Jewish people vote for Democrats, but you know, we won last time. We won Miami. We won areas that nobody's ever won before with Jewish people. But when he didn't pick Shapiro, and I don't think Shapiro was the second best person or the third. I think there were other people better than him. I know them all. And, you know, so, but I was shocked when it came out to the final two that he didn't pick Shapiro. I was very surprised.
Mr. President, here's another soundbite of the current vice president talking about, you know, on her watch with Joe Biden, things are just absolutely great, right? Watch.
In Pennsylvania, we fight for a future with affordable housing, affordable health care, affordable child care, paid leave. We fight for.
All I can say to that, what the vice president is saying, is no lies detected. And I'll show you that in a little while. But listen to his response.
Our future, where we bring down prices that are still too high and lower the cost of living for America's families.
Okay, so there, you know, she is co-pilot to Joe Biden. So while inflation and prices have been through the roof during their administration, now she's trying to put on a happy face about how we're going to turn it all around. Mr. President, I'm sure you've seen over the last week or so, her team has been leaking to the New York Times. You know, all those things we used to stand for, we're not for them anymore because we've adopted all new policies. That's probably one of the reasons why she has not appeared on television. And so she's trying to appear more moderate to appeal to people in the middle, and she's getting away with it. The honeymoon for Kamala Harris, it must drive you crazy because it's still going on.
It does, and there's only one thing, because she's just talking about Pennsylvania. No fracking. That means your energy prices are going to go through the roof, but that means...
You know, Shark, great minds thinking alike, because I was just thinking the same thing. All he's doing is giving Trump the words to say. Trump is not very educated enough to use those big words, so he's leading him into, this is what I want you to talk about next. This is what this teacher does to their students. I'm gonna tell you what to say, little Johnny. Yeah, they're coaching him.
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you what to say, little Johnny. Because remember that when they started talking about the policies, have y'all heard them talking about policies since they mentioned it?
No.
Any policies being mentioned?
They have not talked about a policy, period.
But I thought that was her question. Okay, let's continue.
Pennsylvania is going to lose 500,000 jobs. More important than the 500,000 jobs, they're going to lose tremendous streams of money. She wants no fracking, and she wants no fracking. She's trying to say now that she wants, you know, she's gone through every single thing that was a horror show, and she disavows it.
Remember, he says she wants no fracking.
Now, she disavows the no fracking. If she does no fracking, and she will 100% do it. One thing I've learned about politicians, and you people knew it maybe before me, but I've known it for a long time, their first thought is the thought that they end up doing. She's for no fracking. She's for defund the police. You know, she was the original defunder of the police. She was the original no cash bail, cashless bail, which has caused havoc. And look at how she's destroyed San Francisco. She started it out as the DA in San Francisco with policies that were so bad. It's a crime-ridden place. It went to the greatest city.
Okay, I'm going to stop that there. I didn't get this. I didn't get this clip, but this is just this. I didn't need a clip for this. It's personal information. What he's talking about, this happened in 2004. She was running for office in her first term shortly after she got elected. There was a police that got killed in the Hunters Point Bayview area. Why do I know? Why am I familiar with that, Erica? That's where my ex-wife is from. She's from the Hunters Point Bayview area. So it was a hot topic around my house at that time. Okay, the policemen apparently chased these two kids. One of them got fired. One of them got killed. They based the whole conviction on a 70% idea that the policeman saw who shot and fatally shot the younger policeman. And of course, we all know that San Francisco is a death penalty state, but she refused to go after the death penalty for the alleged killer. Okay, so that was she was considered up until she took office. There was no such thing as a progressive politician. That is fact. Go look it for yourself. But that's what he says that she's so radical about. That's what he's about to point to. Let's continue.
In America, it's a crime-ridden place right now. It's not livable. You can't even live there. And then she went to Attorney General. She's destroyed California. Her and Gavin Newsom have destroyed, absolutely destroyed California. And what a...
She took office in 2004. As he mentioned, Terrace Halligan. That's where she took office from. San Francisco was in a shithole long before Kamala Harris ever came there. Oakland was in a shithole. Crime was high. San Francisco is 14 miles long and 7 miles wide. Looks pretty from the sky, folks. That's it. I lived there, so I know.
shame. What a beautiful place it was, but it's not beautiful anymore. She cannot get away, because if she does this to America, every one of us are going to either be leaving, or we're going to be living like dogs. Our whole country, our whole system is going to collapse. Even the talk about her has driven the stock market down.
Yeah.
You know, when the stock market goes down, when you see it go down, that's because she gets a decent poll number. She gets bounces in a poll, the market goes market will collapse like in 1929 if they're elected.
We know people are pulling a lot of their money out. If you looked at your 401k on Monday, you were in tears. You put on social media, Trump cash versus Kamala crash. And analysts are warning, even though there was a turnaround yesterday, the rebound doesn't mean the market meltdown is over. And when we go out to these diners, Mr. President, this is the number one issue. The economy, inflation, how it's affecting us. People can't retire right now because they're losing their money. The other issue is the border. And you have Tim Walz, who said that if you build this wall that's 25 feet, he wants a ladder factory where he sells ladders or gives ladders to the illegal immigrants that are 30 feet so they can climb the wall. He wants to pay for illegals' health care, just like Kamala Harris does, their tuition, and give them drugs.
I don't know who's worse, Trump or the folks that's interviewing him. I don't know who's worse.
Okay.
Really, they say the governor, the guy that was a governor or senator or Republican or House of Representatives wanted to take ladders to the border. If you build a 25-foot wall, we're going to buy 30-foot ladders so they can get over it. How dumb. We know how dumb they are. Because they're listening to that. Somebody will repeat that. This was just released today. Some of you folks will hear this tomorrow. But this was released today. I guarantee you, this particular will be the talking points for the Republicans for the next own up to the election. Everything that he said today will be repeated over and 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 over.
You mean everything they said today? Because he didn't say it.
Right. Everything they said today. You're right, Sid. You're absolutely right. Sid, Shar, anything before we click this button?
That's it. Yep.
Y'all ain't click the button, man. I'm laughing so hard in the background.
Y'all think y'all slick because I can't see you. I know you got cotton in your ear.
I'm sipping on this Hennessy and laughing.
So. So you self-medicating on this?
I'm self-drinking. That's what I'm doing.
Right. Let's continue. Take a sip.
Just did.
Driver's license. He actually signed that into legislation in his state, and he supports to make Minnesota a sanctuary state. So talk about it is now. Talk about the economy. What you're going to do for the economy, and what you're going to do for the border.
The first thing we're going to do is we're going to drill, baby, drill. And then number two, and I can do lots of things on the first day. It's not one thing or two things or four things. We're going to do lots of things on the first day. But we're going to close up the border. We're going to let people come in, but they have to come in legally. I built 571 miles of wall. We built a lot, much more than I said I was going to build. I was then going to add 200. We were 200 miles. We were 300. Literally, we were just right there. We could have had another 200, almost 300 miles of wall, and they decided not to put it up. I had it made, and they sold it. Brian, they sold it for nothing. They sold it for 5% of the cost. It's very expensive. That wall is exactly what Border Patrol wanted. It wasn't my preference. I had a different wall. I had the most gorgeous wall you've ever seen, but they had to have steel, concrete, and rebar. And that's what it is. Inside that steel is concrete. Inside that is rebar. They needed a certain wall. High tech. It's very high tech. It's all wired for cameras, for everything. I put it up. They sold it for five percent of the cost of building it. And all they had to do is flip it. All they had to do is it was all in place. We would have had 200 miles additionally in. The wall would have been unbelievable. And by the way, walls work. You've heard me say two things work. Everything's obsolete, but two things work. Walls.
I'm sure he's going to get Mexico to pay for it. But anyway, anybody want to comment on that word salad?
No, I don't want to mention anything about his beautiful wall.
Right, because we all know it's a lie. Mexico was going to pay for it, remember?
Right.
Did y'all forget that?
A lot of graffiti on it.
Right.
A lot of graffiti.
Come on. And then a lot of the wall was brand new. You fixed what was already there.
And wheels. They'll never change. Walls and wheels. Everything
Walz
else is
running for vice president now.
Well, Mr. President, we know you dodged an assassination attempt, and we still look at the footage and can't believe, and we're so thankful. The whole country is, even if they're voting for you or not. Mm-hmm. Then there's this story about Asif Mershant. He's 46 years old. He's in New York City. He's got a Pakistani family and a Tehran family. It looks like he was trying to meet with a hitman. Thankfully, the FBI had infiltrated to assassinate you. Your thoughts about this devious plot?
Well, I'll tell you this. I'm in a very dangerous business. Being president is a dangerous thing, and especially when you're an active president, when you're somebody that wants to make our country secure, when you want to build a strong military. I rebuilt our entire military. I mean, we gave a lot of it away to Afghanistan, which is like shocking. That was, by the way, the Afghanistan, when we showed that gross incompetence in Afghanistan, I was getting out, but we were getting out with tremendous dignity and strength. We were the boss. We were going to keep Bagram. If you remember, we were going to keep Bagram because it's literally 1 hour from where China makes its nuclear weapons. They gave Bagram, and China has now assumed control of Bagram, and nobody wants to tell you that. We were going to keep Bagram. But the Afghanistan move was so bad. I think it was the lowest point in the history of our country. It was an embarrassment.
Well, that was a military secret. He just told everybody.
Well, I got to let you know what he, done.
Daughter has over 200 patents in China. Come to find out that he just received a substantial amount of money from a wealthy donor. His son-in-law got over $2 billion from the Saudis.
Which is the reason why they're really trying to win this election? Because I guarantee you, once Kamala and Walz get into office,
they're going to jail.
There's going to be a whole lot of people going to jail.
That's indeed. That's indeed. It's a lot of people that's sitting in Congress right now sweating bullets.
Yes, sir.
Let's continue.
Hey, judges too, man.
I'm sorry. Judges too. Clarence Thomas. Clarence Thomas. That's the only way you can get rid of a Supreme Court judge is to impeach him. He's going to get impeached.
I'm in the history of our country in terms of that. And we gave that up. It was like the right. most horrible thing. And that gave Putin the feeling that, wow, these people are incompetent. I can go into Ukraine. And frankly, as you know, under me, Iran was broke. There was no Hamas threat. There was no Hezbollah.
And Mr. President, also, Kamala Harris was the last one in the room when Joe Biden signed off on that. Meanwhile, one of your favorite people, Lawrence Jones, is live in Sturgis. Lawrence, take it away.
Good.
You have people that have questions for you.
I love that.
Mr. President, how you doing,
Lawrence?
Mr. President? We're live from Sturgis.
Well, if I got to say, y'all know this is a yes boss that's about to speak.
Yeah, I was finna ask, was that an undercover brother, but
yeah. Yeah, yeah. He a yes boss. I'm not going to even call him an undercover brother. He's a straight yes boss, Sambo.
Okay.
Just say hello to the so.
See, it even sound like he said it. Even sound like he said, "Sambo, I'm over here."
You know who else I can't stop laughing at?
Who
is those black people that stand behind Trump at his rallies, like?
It's hilarious for them to be holding up that sign, isn't it? Hilarious.
It's going to happen. It's going to happen again. We've got to get the energy prices down, and everything else is going to be tumbling down with it, the prices, because what Biden has done to the economy is so horrible, and what he's done to inflation in our country is just very destructive.
Mr. President, it's the perfect segue. It's the perfect transition, Mr. President, because I met Linda at the airport yesterday, and when I
talked to her and I said, what is the number one concern? She's concerned about Kamala Harris and her energy policy. What is your question for the former president?
Mr. President, what can we do to achieve a permanent long-term energy solution to keep us energy independent?
Such a great question. Mr. President?
It's a great question. It's such an important question. And look, we're run by people that are not smart people, okay? Not smart people. We have more liquid gold, you've heard me say this a million times, under our feet than any other country. Russia, Saudi Arabia, you can add them all up. We have more than anybody. We were energy independent 4 years ago, and now we're begging Venezuela for oil. Venezuela, they don't even have oil. They have a tar. You have to take tar, and you have to refine it. It's a terrible process. We have the best, the most beautiful, the best, highest quality oil under our feet. Texas and numerous other places, we have the best stuff. We don't use it. Because Biden does, he talks about the environment. You know, it's amazing. They talk about the environment, and yet we refine the Venezuelan tar, okay? We refine it, and it goes up into our air. It's done in Houston, the only plant that can do it. We are going to bring the energy costs down. Everything else is going to be tumbling, and we don't need energy from any other country. We have, and we have to fill up the strategic reserves again. It's down. It's the lowest number it's ever been. He's using the strategic reserves, which is meant for military, which is meant for war and very important things. He's using it to try and keep gasoline prices down, and we can't allow that to happen. We have to fill up the strategic. I was filling that up at levels that they've never seen before. We have to fill up the strategic reserves. People use that to fill a car. We will have the energy prices to a point where they're as low or lower than they were 4 years ago. Yep. But remember, I had you down to $1.87 a gallon, and that was beautiful. They were good times. Thank
Mr.
you.
Mr. President, it was a good time. I drive a big truck, so I remember that. Got one last question for you. A lot of folks here talking about Social Security, and this gentleman has a question on that point.
Yeah, Mr. President, a lot of seniors, their only income is Social Security. Last year, they had adjustable income of 1.2%. Meanwhile, inflation was probably 7% or higher. How about making it mandatory, whatever inflation is, that that would be the income for the Social Security instead of this 1.2% pathetic adjustment?
Mr. President?
I got it. It's a great question. We can do a lot of things to help the people. People on Social Security are being killed. And one of the things I'm doing is no tax for seniors on Social Security, and I'll get it done quickly. No tax for seniors on Social Security. And for all you waiters and waitresses and everybody else out there, drivers, we're not going to have any tax on tips. No tax on tips. Remember that. No tax on tips. But we're going to have no tax for seniors on Social Security, and they are they're going to destroy Social Security because millions of people are coming into our country and security. They're putting them on Medicare. They're putting them on all of our things. They're destroying it. They are destroying Social Security. We're going to make, and remember, I was there for 4 years. I didn't raise the age. They wanted to raise the age. They wanted lots of things. I said, no way. We left Social Security the way it was. Well, now we're doing no tax for seniors. You deserve that. We have plenty of other things. We have, I told you about liquid gold. Yeah. We have more than anybody else. We don't have to do that. We don't have to hurt people on Social Security. We are going to do no tax for Social Security, and also no tax on tips for the waiters that are standing right next to you.
So, Mr. President, I'm going to send it back to the couch, but the people here are going to kill me if I don't ask you. They want to know, will President Trump be at the next Sturgis?
We don't give a damn whether President Trump going to be at the next Sturgis rally or not. I don't care. What we just heard just now was, I counted 53, 57 lies, 51 lies in that one statement. Donald Trump has every plan to dismember the so-called entitlement programs. He has every plan to do that. He plans to strip Social Security. He planned to raise the minimum retirement age. He plans to do all of that under the guise of Project 2025, folks. Don't believe me? Go look it up for yourself. Don't believe me? Go look it up for yourself. Everything that he said in this 20-30 minute interview was an absolute lie. How can I prove it? Folks can ask me, how can you prove what you say, just what you were saying? Okay. Said, go ahead. Before I get to the proof, go ahead. Said.
Well, the one thing that I focused on was when the lady asked about the energy independence, like Republicans have never wanted that. They never wanted energy independence. You got too many oil barons.
That's where the old money's at. That's where the old right. money's at.
And America, what a lot of people don't even understand about the oil that we have here, there's a reason why we don't use the oil that we have here. I don't know if people realize it or whatnot, but that oil is just sitting there because eventually Saudi Arabia, Venezuela, Russia, Iran, they're going to run out of oil. And
the thing about the oil, and I agree what you're saying, was one thing about oil is it's you can get it from, we do produce, we're one of the major producers, the main producers of oil, but it's on the global market. You can buy it from China, you can buy it from Saudi Arabia. There's so many different countries that you can buy oil from.
Right. So my point is, why use up all the oil here when we can use up all the oil there, from there, and from over there, and from over there? And then when the oil run out, guess who got all the oil?
Our strategic reserves is stockpiled. Who ran the medical reserves out? Trump did. So I don't know what he's talking about. But remember, folks, Trump said that Harris administration didn't have a clean record, that they, everything that he said, look for yourself. When President Biden and Vice President Harris took office, the country faced unprecedented crisis and facing, let me scroll up a little bit more, lowering the cost of families and everyday experience. This is a top accomplishment, folks. Let me pause it for a minute. What you see here, everything that Trump said, I just literally went to whitehouse.gov. For folks that say this is not a reliable source, you can't get no more reliable than this. This is all the top accomplishments of the Biden-Harris administration. They have not been in office a complete 4 years yet. Let's continue. Inflation Reduction Act. This is important to most folks, that because America as a population is getting much older, folks, and America as a population is overweight. So to cap off the insulin charge at $35, this was something major to keep the Affordable Health Care Act in place. Just read along with this. If you need to, you can pause it. But I'm not going to do much talking doing this. Folks, said and sure, if you can see this, if you need something, if you want to stop on something and point out something, just say, hey, pause that for a minute. All right. Okay, before I go any further, yeah, and just in case, folks, if this turns out to be blurry on the upload, what I'll do is I'll put the link down in the description, and you can go read this. All everything that you see in front of you here, folks, you can actually click on, and it'll give you a more a breakdown, a physical breakdown of everything that you say here, see here, like the two of the strongest years of job growth. You heard Trump try to claim that, said that it was unprecedented from him. Well, at that point in time, you might have been right, but the Biden-Harris administration blew you out the water. Okay, increased the maximum value of the Pell Grant from $900. I think the Pell Grant used to be $300, $400, $500. They moved that up to $900. That's just to get you into school so folks can walk into school and get books. Okay, millions of Americans are saving $800 per day on $800 a year on health insurance. They raised the minimum health wage from $7.50 an hour to $15 an hour. 3.5 unemployment rate. More than 40 million borrowers stand to benefit from the student loan debt relief. Has Trump talked about any of that in that clip that we saw earlier? I'll let y'all in on that. Come on.
He can't. He wasn't even willing to do any of this stuff.
None of this. Let's continue. Again, folks, if the words on the screen are kind of blurry, then just let me know. Well, I'll have the link down in the description. Well, you can't really let me know, but I'll have the link down in the description so you can go read this for yourself. Taking over 100 actions to lower household energy costs by $100 per year. Near record low unemployment rate for Hispanics. 750,000 new manufacturing jobs. Fully vaccinated, 75%, 9% of America vaccinated for the COVID-19 vaccine. Near record low unemployment rate for African Americans. The record unemployment rate is at 4.2 or something like 3.4 or something like that. 16 million households receiving low cost or free high speed internet. Record low unemployment for people with disabilities. Put your email and your zip code, sign up. All right, folks, do it for yourself. Got a little bit more history. 11 million jobs in 17 states, 11 states. Come on. Moving on. The first meaningful gun violence reform in over 30 years. In over 30 years, the first meaningful gun violence. But you hear Trump say that the Biden-Harris administration is the worst that's ever been. Well, those are facts and figures, undisputed. Char, Sid, anything?
No, I just ignore him. So,
Well, listen, folks. You don't have to believe me. The proof is in the pudding.
No, the proof is definitely in the pudding. I mean, think about all the mass shootings that we had, and yeah. Democrats have tried to push bills to keep that stuff from happening. And who fights it?
Right.
When we had mass shootings, I think we had that, wasn't Trump in office when they had the mass shooting in Vegas where the guy got the hotel?
Yes, he was. And they wanted to, his administration, remove the bump stock. Obama administration restricted it, but he allowed it to be sold again. So, no, don't tell me how much you got gun reform. You haven't talked about policies. But anyway, one more thing before we get out of here, folks. And this is a head-to-head Biden. I want more folks to think that I'm getting a suit now like Trump.
Yeah, because Trump appeared got back in the race. He really would.
Yeah, he really won't that. But this is Vice President Harris, stacked up against former President Trump. The choice is clear, folks. Y'all look at this for yourself. All righty there, ladies and gentlemen. As we can see right there, you can just see just Harris versus Trump stacked up. The choice is clear, if you ask me. I don't know about you folks. I don't want to know how you vote, and that's really not of my concern. Let me get this off the screen here. Hold on just a second. What did I do here? All right, there we are. Before we get out of here, Shar, and that's final thoughts on what we talked about and what we saw here today.
Well, all I could say is if there will be a debate, it can only be on Fox.
That would be the only safe place for him, sure, is on Fox.
Right.
I think I understand exactly what you mean by that. That's the only place that you will get thrown them softball questions. Sid?
I'm with Char on that. I'm right behind you, Char. I feel the same way. I feel that whatever happens with the debate, she's either going to be debating by herself, or she's on Fox and do it and still make the man look bad. So, I mean, either way, it's a lose-lose for him.
Yeah, I think either way, it's a lose-lose situation there, folks. Again, I don't want to know who you folks out there voting for, but again, I think if you are worried about those so-called inalienable rights and those freedoms that we all possess here in the United States, I would suggest that you go take a look at Project 2025 and what they plan to do. I would suggest you go back and you look at, in not just my video, but there's several videos out there that will tell you that Trump has no policies. And then you hear that on those folks over there saying that the Biden Harris administration is the worst administration since God knows how long. VP Harris is the worst vice president since and forever. I guess they forgot who Spiro Agnew was. And that technically, for all intents and purposes, he should have been put in jail. I guess they forgot who Richard Nixon was. I guess they forgot that Bill Clinton had was having, more than likely, he got caught having oral sex in the White House. But y'all know he did more. Y'all know it. I was listening to a stream earlier where they was trying to big up John F. Kennedy. Well, if you look at it, there's only been one president that's been clean. That's been Obama. His record is impeccable in the White House. I dare anyone throw stones there. He wasn't a philanthropist. He wasn't a cheater. All politicians lie. And last thing, Trump is so hell-bent on immigration. Who the fuck did you mad to, Trump?
That is the thing that's been bothering me, because both of them have wives that's immigrants.
Immigrants. Let it make sense.
Figure it out.
He got paper.
But look, ladies and gentlemen, until next week, we'll come back with a brand new topic. We'll try and keep you posted as much as we can on the election, upcoming election over here, the do's and the don'ts, and the highs and the lows. Till then, watch your 3, your 6, and your 9. Say hello to somebody, and check out Dreadhead Said once you tell them about your show tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah, Thursday. My show is definitely tomorrow night. It's called the Hookah and Hennessy Radio Show. And I play a variety of music, so I'm not just a one-term. You sound like Trump now. A one-term.
You're right. He's just not a one T. He's not a one turntable DJ, folks. Is what he's trying to say.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say.
He got two. He got two.
No, actually, I got six. But
but he used two. Okay, he got six.
Yeah, I used two at a time. Two.
Right. So y'all come check him out. The Hook and Hennessy Show. What time is that? Said 8 p.m.
starts at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 p.m. Central Time. Central Time. Right. So if you're in the Chicago area, definitely check me out. I'm at 7 o'clock p.m.
Right.
And Thursday.
Every Thursday. And now, folks, if you're out and about, you can listen to it, of course, on the website. But if you would like to, you can also drop down to the listening lounge. Said is usually in there. I'm in there. Shar, you're usually in there. A few other folks. So come on in, drop on in. Interactive. You can check me out on Sundays and Tuesdays. But Music Cafe on Sundays, playing a different variety of music, and the jazz show on Tuesday night. So that'll be what's today? I forgot already. Today Wednesday, ain't it?
Yeah.
Damn. don't judge me. It's been a long day. It's raining here. I'm stir crazy. I like being outside. I'm stir crazy.
It's some floods.
Right. Rain here. You know, they say it's gonna rain and then it don't rain.
Yeah.
Like it looked like it's finna rain. The other day it looked like it was finna storm and nothing. We ain't even get a lightning strike.
Right. I'm going to speak for all the people here in South Carolina that say, be careful what you ask for. Well, with that, ladies and gentlemen, we out of here. Again, like, share, and subscribe. And if you want to leave a comment, please feel free to. But I done warned you now, and I told you, if you leave a nasty grab, don't think I'm just going to block your comment. I'm going to leave it there. But then I'm going to come to your spot and leave you a nasty grab too, all right? So with that, we out here, folks. Have a good one.